Katie Minocci, I'm a freshman, and we are from Westside.
Westside?
This poem is called Voice Memo Number 4. This summer, I couldn't see straight. I called all my friends in quick succession, begged them to come get me, held my brain in my head with the press of my hand against my heart. At least I could say it was still beating, not just barely thumping, but pounding, echoing loudly in my ears, running faster than the breath I could catch. I followed his example. 3 blocks before I broke up down street lamps, blurring into flash lines of color, a dash line turned to face in my sanity. The parking lot was empty, but I could still hear the whirring of my wheels, the sputter of my engine. The car was off, but I was still moving too quickly, still racing across avenues of anxiety, breath. To each other, one after another, until my face became close up, claustrophobic, too crowded to take the oxygen. I huffed and I puffed, and I don't feel real.
I whispered into my phone's welcoming ear. There's no one on the other end but silence and a machine designed to record my every word. I've said anything at all, contained in the rise and fall of the line, the soft hillside and never-ending road. All I can think is that at least they're going somewhere, not just stewing in my car's putrid air.
I don't know how to fix it.
I can feel them warm inside the cool glass of my phone. As the clock ticks, my chest fills, words sinking into the hollow space of my breast, hope bubbling in my throat, my breathing slows.
Help me.
My heartbeat, like a metronome, resets my rhythm as the recording ticks ever onward.
Please.
Keys turn and my car pulls away from the parking lot.
Please. The drive takes me to an all-too-familiar location. Comfort food tastes like QT hot chocolate, and anything that's bad for me, it's wrapped in memories of nights like these spent cruising in the passenger seat with people who could steer when the street lamps turned to slash-lined. My first bite is the moment my seatbelt turns from a noose to a comfort blanket, the moment my frantic phone calls and muttered prayers accumulate in a porch light and a friend stepping through the doorway. Hello.
Thank you for helping me.